Yep. It's Miss Irma Thomas from New Orleans, like I am. I'm from New Orleans as well. But she would stop raining because it's been raining too much lately. But anyway, I thought I'd just put that on there and let you get started here. And I tell you what, it's been a while since I've done one of these videos. So good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever it is. I'm here. It's whatever I feel like doing, it seems like. I tell you what. No, I was, Quakey was kind of joking with me. He's like, yeah, when you going to do it again? And he's like, you just don't want to do it. And I'm like, it's not that. It's not that I don't want to do it. It's just I've been working so hard. It's been busy. I've been doing a lot of stuff. I think the last time I did one of these, I think I just called the high school football championship game at Superdome and on the radio. So I forgot about that. And I think that might've been the last time I did a video, and I know I didn't do it over the holidays, but I know I missed you, but Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. And of course here it's right now, Happy Mardi Gras. So yeah, it's Mardi Gras season, but parades don't actually start for about another week, I think it is. I think it's the end, maybe this weekend I think they start this weekend, if I'm not mistaken. Or they're supposed to start this weekend. Who knows the weather or any of that. But yeah, Mardi Gras. And yeah, and if I was on TikTok, I'd actually make a little money. I think I made 13 cents for wearing this shirt one time when I did a TikTok live. But I tell you what, I'm moving up. I'm over 7,800 there. I'm about to hit 1.8K on YouNow as far as fans. And, you know, I think I decided I'm probably going to try to get to around, if I can get to around 2,000 fans, I think at that point I'll go ahead and make my push to be a partner on YouNow. And so we got that going on and just all kind of stuff going on. Speaking of Quakey, I'm going back in March. March 2nd, I'm leaving here. March 4th, I'll be arriving in Manila, and we're going to be doing all kind of stuff this time around. We're going to be doing traveling. We're actually going to travel to two different locations. And the first 11 days, the first night, we're just going to stay. Got a little hotel in Manila, and then we're going to be going to Gaytay, Boracay. We'll be doing that back to back. We're going to rent a car and go to Gaytay, and then we're going to come back, then go to the airport and fly over to Boracay. So we'll do that. And then my birthday will be coming up. We'll also be celebrating our 18 months together. So all that's going to be coming up. And that's what we got going on. But anyway, getting back to what I was talking about. Just get back doing a video again. You know, that's what I wanted to do. So, all right. So that's what I wanted to do. And actually, I'm going to try something different. Probably do an exit song too. I'll probably do an exit song. I'm going to go ahead and try to. That I just have that ready. Oh yeah, it'll be ready. Yeah, and what I'll do is this. Hold on, got that down. Yep. All right, so I'll just leave it right there. Okay, so I'll be set. But yeah, that's what I wanted to talk about. Of course, as far as the New Orleans Saints, this season ended. Blah blah blah. We know what happened. 7-10. Bringing everybody, pretty much all the coaches back. So I think they fired one guy, the tight ends coach. Like, yeah, that was your big problem offensively. Yeah, that was it. Yeah, that was it. That's all you need to do. That's fine. We'll just have to have another year about this, and we just have to deal with it. It is what it is. Move on, and we'll worry about what happens. We first got to find out what's going to happen with Sean Payton. Who's he going to go to coach? Where is he going to be, the next head coach at? And I right now, I think it's the Denver Broncos. I think it's going to be the Denver Broncos. I just think they can make it work as far as the compensation to the Saints. I think they're good there. It'll be the 23rd pick, but oh well. It is what it is, you know? It is what it is. So if that's what you get, that's what you get, you know? As long as you got a pick in the first round. Because currently, they don't have a pick in the first round. And man, my neck is like itching. I feel like it needs to be stretched out or something. LSU finished with their big bowl game, and they're signing a lot of recruits and also going after the transfer portal and doing what they got to do with that. So all that's happening. But, I mean, they just wallop Purdue, and that game's 63-7. It's like, oh, boy, that was big. But I think more buzz is going on around about Tulane, how they finished their football season. And I tell you what, that was a fantastic finish of the Cotton Bowl. Oh, my God. It's like you think when USC goes up by 15 points, you think it's over. You think it's, oh, that's it. It's done. It's done. It's done. But I tell you, it's just, you know, the way things transpired, it's like Tulane hurries up and scores. I mean, they score in a hurry. Boom. Get back, you know, get back within eight. Then they kick off the ball. The USC offensive, I mean, the kick returner, for some reason, decides to touch the ball at the 1 yard line. Instead of the ball, look, he leaves it alone. That ball's going out of bounds. So they get the ball on the 35-yard line after the penalty, and they could probably try to put the game away. Well, instead, the guy touches the ball, rolls out to one, and then they get the ball there. Tulane gets a safety, and then gets the ball, and then goes down the field and gets the winning touchdown and ends the game. So basically, that's what they did. They didn't have to go for two because they had already had the 2-point the safety, so they didn't need the 2-point conversion. So they got so instead of being tied the game, they went up by 1 point and then held on and won. So congratulations to them. I mean, you got most of that team coming back. I don't see any reason why they can't win the American Athletic Conference again, win the whole thing again, and probably go to a New Year's Six again. Unless they go undefeated, maybe get a shot like TCU did at the CFP. So we'll see. It just depends. It depends on a lot of things, but we'll have to see. But, man, my hat's off to them. And you know, at least our college teams, our main college teams did well. So that was a good thing. They got well. So there you go. So let's see. I think that's all the sports I want to talk about, except maybe the Pelicans. Boy, they need to get their big two back. They need Brandon Ingram and Zion Williamson back as soon as possible. Because what they're doing now is they're playing these games. They're competitive, but they're running out of gas in the fourth quarter. So, yeah, that's got to change. This could get away from them in a hurry. I think they went down to the fourth seed now. They were the first seed, and then they get injured, and they drop down. So we'll have to see. We'll have to see what happens there. We got a while to go for that, so we don't have to worry about that right now. Let's see what else. Personally, yeah, like I said, TikTok, I'm over 7,800 now, trying to get to 10K. And anybody who doesn't follow me on TikTok now, come over, and you got an account, come over and follow me. Let's get to 10K. That's what I want to do. I want to get there and be good there. And obviously, I'm just about to hit 1.8K on you now. So try to get my role to get to 2. If I get to 2K fans and get a few subscribers. Right now, I got one subscriber on both TikTok and you now. And it's, of course, Corky. So he takes care of me. Yep. So, yeah, he's doing really, really well with that relationship. We went over the 16-month mark. So we're closing in on 17 months. And like I said, when I'm there, we'll be celebrating our 18 months together. So got that going on. So yeah, so all that's happening. I am moving my open mic, my You Now open mic stream that I do currently on Friday nights. I'm moving it officially Saturday afternoons, 1 p.m. Eastern. So it's going to be over there on You Now, and eventually I'm probably going to put it on TikTok as well. So we'll probably do like a dual stream, but we're hearing that there's rumors running around that we may be able to simulcast. So yeah, this might be something they're planning on doing. Because right now, you can simulcast on YouTube. I can't figure out how to activate my account to take live broadcast. I wish I could figure it out. I cannot figure out what's going on with my YouTube account. Well, I can't do it. But man, because right now you can simulcast your YouNow broadcast on TikTok. Well, I mean, YouTube. They're trying to. The word is they're looking into the possibility of simulcasting on also instead of, you know, not just YouTube, but simulcasting on TikTok and on Twitch. So that might, some of the guys who left YouNow and went over to Twitch, that might be something that gets them back over to YouNow. And they can do YouNow and Twitch concurrently, side by side. So I think that would be a good thing. I would obviously do it with TikTok. Because I would definitely want to put that on my TikTok. So, my TikTok account. So, yeah, that would be big. If we could get that. And if we get simulcast, and that'd be easy. Then, boom. I don't know if it's going to be... I don't know if it's going to be one, I think it's still going to... I'm still going to probably need a second device to read the chat on the other stream. So, yeah. So that'll probably happen. But I tell you, it's been good. Feeling good. So, I'm not talking about vaccines or getting them, not getting them. I'm not getting into any of that stuff. I'm not an expert. I'm not planning on being or trying to be. So I'm not going to mention it. That way YouTube doesn't ban or kick, so they did that to where I said something about Dr. F, I'll just say. I won't go any further than that. I said something about Dr. F and they kicked it off and had to do a whole new video. So I'm not getting involved in that. So don't, right. Yeah, people, won't you speak one way or the other? I'm three times vaccinated, that's it. I'm not going to say anything else. oh, that's nice. Zion Williamson to miss two more weeks. Okay, well. Brandon Ingram started trip practice, so hopefully maybe he gets back and he'll loosen the load on the rest of the team, because you got guys that shouldn't be starters that are starting right now. So, all right. Well, I'm trying to think of anything else I want to talk about before I get out of here. Yeah, I'm hanging at this apartment. Most definitely I want to talk about this. My friend John Gerber is running for sheriff in St. Tammany Parish. If you live in St. Tammany Parish, get to know who John Gerber is. Look at his Facebook account, all his social media, and everything he's going to do. He's going to post it. He's going to officially announce the campaign. Probably, I don't know. It sounds like maybe after Mardi Gras now. But we're going to have the official launch. I'm part of his team. Yes, I am. Even though I live in Baton Rouge, I'm part of his team because... quite frankly, he wins the election, I'm going to be part of his team. So I'll just say it that way. But Randy Smith is a total disaster. He's a piece of work. I'll just say that. He is a piece of work. Yeah, I will say that because, I don't want to go into anything else. There's videos running around about him doing different things. So that'll all come out when it's supposed to. Don't worry about that. My friend Bernie Cyrus is handling this campaign. One of my co-workers over, well, my former co-workers over at WGSO. So yeah, I produced this show a few times. So yeah, a couple of Fridays, I think I did. A few Fridays, maybe, that I produced this show. So among other people that I produce shows for around there, but yeah. We're going to do that, and I think I'm going to get on out of here. I think I'm going to get out of here. We'll see. I think it's going to play. Nope, wrong thing.
World War One promised us.
Oops. Wrong thing. I was trying to end this. There we go. Because from Irma Thomas to Supertramp. Because it is. It's raining again. So, on that note, God willing, I'll talk to you again in a little while. Bye now. Let the hit go.
Raining again.